share a little bit with us what are the most interesting areas in alternative data that you are seeing?
Yeah, so one of the most interesting areas that I'm seeing in alternative data is the use of natural language processing to analyze unstructured information like news, filings, transcripts, anything that's being said and being captured in text, and being able to use technologies to make sense of all that text and how and what it means to financial markets.
So what are some of the major challenges you see in incorporating new data sets into hedge funds?
Right, so most hedge funds are looking for structured data. They obviously want to get data sets that are clean, that have long histories, that have a good track record at being produced and curated, and quality is an important part of what they're looking for. Most hedge funds will want to ensure that the vendors that provide those data sets are well known and recognized. And the major challenge to overcome is to have enough history yourself as a company to demonstrate that you check the boxes on all the things that they need even before they think about testing your data. So it's building a pedigree to a certain extent so that once you get to the point where you can literally provide them with the information they need, then that they you have a bigger chance of success.
So how do you see the big data landscape evolving?
Right, so I see the big data landscape evolving in many different ways. For starters, there will be a lot more data providers, more companies that specialize in capturing specific types of data that solve problems that are sector specific. There might be data sets that are used for healthcare. There might be other data sets that are used for consumer electronics or retail. So you will see a lot of these new data companies producing these very segmented data sets. And on the other hand, you're going to see companies like Grave Impact that are going to be focusing on bigger, broader data sets like the web, like news, social media, where more participants talk about things that move markets. And the technologies are going to have to catch up to make sense of all that information because it's going to be a lot and more than it is today. And it's going to be harder and harder to process where, as humans, we're going to fall short. So we're going to need some better tools to be able to use it.
Mm-hmm. Then where do you see Raven Pack in the next 5 years?
I see Rave Impact growing over the next 5 years, both in terms of size, right? The team has already exceeded 100 people. We were 40 2 years ago. I also see Rave Impact growing into other markets. We've been very lucky to have good success in financial services and have some amazing customers there, but we're now starting to grow outside of finance and looking into corporate markets, specifically whether it's energy or healthcare or segments where we can add value through sentiment analysis and other unstructured data set analysis that we do. And then finally, I see us entering the what is called the private data business, which is essentially helping customers leverage or monetize their own internal digital assets. So not just focusing on public information, but licensing our technology to help them make sense of the information that lives behind their own firewalls.
Thank you, Amanda.
My pleasure.
Thank you.